It was in 1668 that the good ship Nonsuch left Gravesend for the Hudson Bay area of Canada. When it returned in 1670, its cargo of beaver pelts was sold at auction for £1,378. Later that year, the merchant adventurers who'd paid for the Nonsuch's trip were granted a royal charter by King Charles II. The Hudson Bay Company was born. Over the next 300 years, trappers and hunters in the northern parts of North America provided most of the rest of the world with the furs which consumers demanded. The Hudson Bay Company's head office moved to Canada in 1970, but its London office remained, the oldest trading company in the city, until it was sold to a Finnish company 2.5 years ago. Now it's moving its operations to Helsinki too.
Well, there's been a massive entrepôt business in the City of London, which has developed over many years, and the Hudson's Bay Company was a central part of this. So it is sad that that will be lost to the City of London, and indeed to the balance of payments for the country.
What about the historical loss?
This historical loss is again sad because the roots go back, as you noted, to 1670 when it was founded. And those links probably in effect were severed to a certain extent 2 years ago when the company was sold by the Canadian parent company.
Animal rights groups are claiming the company's move as a victory. They say their publicity work to stop women wearing furs as fashion has caused the trade in fur in this country to drop dramatically.
Sales have not dropped alarmingly, sales have increased alarmingly. I would say alarmingly because it's almost a desperate battle sometimes for the producers to match that demand. But they have now done so, and next year's crop will be even bigger than last year's crop. So that is a strange irony to see it in its proper light.
Nevertheless, animal rights groups will be pleased that the Hudson Bay Company is moving from London to Helsinki. And when it does so in September, one other result of the move is that when its building is then pulled down, it's possible that extensions to the famous Roman baths found under adjacent buildings could be revealed. And that'll please archaeologists too. Christopher Rainbow for Thames News.